Dear students, good morning. Today we studied about that as a female reproductive system. Last class we will discuss about the male reproductive system clearly and thoroughly. Okay, so in this class we will learn about female reproductive system. So where it is located, the female reproductive system? The female reproductive system is located in pelvic region. Where it is located, the female reproductive system is located in pelvic region. Okay, so what are the parts it's included in that female reproductive system? So the first one is a pair of ovaries. So what is the organ of a male reproductive system? Is testis. Very good. So what is the female reproductive organ? Is ovaries. So next is a pair of oviduct. So in the oviduct is otherwise it is called as a fallopian tube or uterine duct. Okay, so next is uterus, and next cervix, and next vagina, and next is external genitalia. So these are the parts is occurring female reproductive system. Now we clearly studied about that the structures. Okay, first how to draw the female reproductive system. So this is the vaginal part. Listen, so this is the vaginal part, this is the vagina. The female reproductive system is start with vagina, and next is, so this part is cervix. So this is the canal like structure that is called as a cervical canal. And next is, this is the U shaped is a uterus. So what is the head of the portions? Is fundus. Next, which is having a fallopian tube. What is the other name of a fallopian tube? Oviduct or uterine duct. Okay, so what are the parts in fallopian tube? So this is the isthmus, and next it will be followed by ambula. The end of the infundibulum, it is a look like structure, is a funnel shaped. So this is the infundibulum, and next it is, which is having a finger like fimbriae. So in this the fimbriae which is having the ovary. Can you understand? So in the fallopian duct, so the infundibulum is a funnel shaped, is a finger like fimbriae, so which is having a ovary. The uterus, the pelvic cavity of the uterus and this ovary, it will be attached. So this part is called as a mesovarium or ligament. Mesovarium, ligament. Okay. Now we understand each and every structures clearly. Okay. So the first is a oviduct, uterus, vagina. So these are the three parts is called as the accessory duct. What are the accessory ducts of the female reproductive system? Oviduct, uterus, vagina. And next, in the female reproductive system is having a pair of a mammary glands. What is the purpose of a mammary glands? It will be nourishment of offsprings. So these all parts are integrated structurally and functionally to support the process of, one is the ovulation, and next is fertilization, and next is pregnancy, and next is parturition and childcare. So these are the five main functions it can be structurally and functionally to support by female reproductive system. Okay. Next is, this is the structure of this sectional view through this pelvis. So this is the cervix. Next is this cervix, below is a rectum. And this part is called as a vagina. And next is anus. So this is the vaginal orifice. And this external organs of external genitalia of this. So this part is called as a labia majora. And next is labia minora. This one is the mons pubis, and which is having the clitoris. So these are the structure of this, the external genitalia of female reproductive system. So I already draw this diagram, so you have to Now understand clearly. Okay, first part is start with vagina, and next it will be followed by cervical canal. So this is the cervix. The cervix is followed by, so there is a uterus. The uterus, which is having a three layer, the outer layer is called as a perimetrium, and middle layer is called as a myometrium, and inner layer is called as the endometrium. So this is the fundus of this uterus, and these are the fallopian duct. This is the fallopian duct or fallopian tube. It start with isthmus, ambula and infundibulum. So in this, the isthmus, the junction between the isthmus and ampullary, that is a takes place of fertilization. Where it is takes place the fertilization? That is the ambulary isthmic junction. So in this place the fertilization takes place. Okay, and it's followed by a fimbriae, so which is having a ovary. Next is female gonads or structure of ovaries. So the ovaries is the primary female sex organs, and it will be produced the female gamete. It will be produced the female gamete. So what is the female steroid hormones? One is the estrogen and the progesterone. What is the male steroid hormones? Is the androgen or testosterone. Okay, so next is where it is located, the ovaries. This ovaries is located in the lower abdomen. Correctly, it's the uterus is located in the pelvic cavity, but the ovaries is located in the lower abdomen. What is the length of the ovaries? Each ovary, which is having a 2 to 4 centimeter in length. So these, it will be connected by a pelvic wall and uterus, the pelvic wall and uterus by ligaments. The ligaments is otherwise it is called as the mesovarium. What is the other name of this ligaments? That is called as the mesovarium. Okay, so next is each ovary is covered by a thin epithelium. So these are the thin epithelium is encloses a ovarian stroma. And ovarian stroma, which is having a two zones, one is outer cortex and inner medulla. The outer cortex, which is having a filled with the follicles, and as inner medulla, which is having filled with the blood vessels, ovarian ligaments as present. So this is the structure of ovary. Listen, so the first, the structure of this is this part, this is the structure of ovary. Which is having a start with primary follicles, and these are the primary follicles. It will be mature to forming a egg, so it forming a secondary follicle. So this is the cells, small follicles it will be formed, and will be around a granulosa cells. So the granulosa cells is a secondary follicles. Next it will be followed by some mature ovum. So these are the ovulated ovum. It will be released at the ovulation. Next is the, after releasing of this ovum, that is called as the corpus luteum. So the corpus luteum is responsible to secreting a progesterone hormone. The progesterone will be is a pregnancy. Transverse sections of ovaries. So developing a follicles in different stages, that is primary follicles, secondary follicles. So this is like us. And next is the primary follicles is developed into a graafian follicle with mature ovum. How it will be forming a graafian follicle, ma? So it's some in oogenesis we will learn about clearly, because the primary follicle, it will be undergo the meiosis division, the prophase 1 conditions, it go for the resting stage. Which condition it will be undergo the resting stage? In prophase. So in this condition, the first primary follicles to forming a secondary follicles, and secondary follicles to forming a antrum. This is the granulosa cells. Okay, the antrum, it will be develops to forming a follicles, that is the graafian follicles. Okay, next is the one may choose around 14th day of the menstrual cycle. It will be ruptures to release the oocyte, that is called as a ovulation. every after completing the menstrual cycle, the 14th day is called as a ovulation day or ovulation phase. Okay, so in what does occur, what is the main process occur in this ovulation? That is a ruptures and to release the oocytes, menstrual cycles and ruptures to release the oocytes. When it will be takes place? So, sorry, where it is occur? At the 14th day of completing the menstrual cycles. Okay, after release the follicle filled with blood clot and then yellow cells called the corpus luteum. So what is the name of the hormone is present in this corpus luteum? Is progesterone. What is the name of the hormone? That is progesterone. Okay, so next is oviducts. The oviducts, what is the other name of the oviduct? It's a fallopian tubes or uterine tubes. Okay, and next is uterus, vagina. So these both is called as the accessory duct. Okay, next it will be followed by the sectional view of the reproductive system. So the first one is accessory ducts. What is accessory ducts? Oviduct, uterus, vagina. So the oviduct is otherwise it is called as a fallopian tube. So this is the fallopian tube. Fallopian tube. Its the length is 10 to 12 centimeter from periphery of each ovary to the uterus. So next is a part closer to ovary funnel shape. What is a funnel shape? So this part is called as the infundibulum and is the edges which having a finger like projections. So this is the finger like projections, the edges of this the funnel shaped infundibulum, that is called as the fimbriae. So what is the role of the fimbriae? It will be collects the ovum. When it will be collect the ovums? It's a after ovulation. Where it does occur the ovulation? Is 14th day. So the wider part oviduct, which is consist of your ambula and isthmus as a narrow lumen, and it will be joints uterus. Okay, so next is a uterus or womb and vagina. So there is a single uterus, is where it is located, is present in a lower abdomen region, and it's called as a womb. So what is the shape of the uterus? Is a hollow inverted pear shaped and attached to the pelvic wall by ligaments, and inside the uterus it's a fertilized ovum grows and develops into an embryo. So this is the opens into the cervix, and cervix it will be followed by cervical canal, and cervical canal along with the vagina. So both it will be called as the cervical canal plus vagina, that is called as a birth canal. And what are the three layer of your uterus? One is the perimetrium, say external thin membranes, and another one is myometrium, is the middle thick layer of your smooth muscles. So it will be helpful to strongest contraction during the delivery. And endometrium, listen, one question is asking from this. The myometrium, it will be strong contraction for during delivery. But endometrium, it will be the cyclic changes during a menstrual cycle. Can you understand? Menstrual cycle, cyclic changes occur endometrium. During delivery, the strong contraction of the uterus is occur in myometrium. Okay. Next is external genitalia of the female reproductive organ. I already tell that. So this is structure of the female external genitalia organ. And Mons pupis, the Mons pupis is, it will be having a, it's a fatty tissue is covered with the hair like cells. And this is a larger layer of the lip-like structure that is called as a labia majora. So this is the fleshy folds of tissue surrounded the vaginal opening. And this, which is having another one is a labia minora. So which is also a pad folds of tissue under labia majora. And next is this one is a glitoris. It's a tiny finger-like structure at the upper junction of the two labia majora. And is having a hymen, its opening of the vagina during a turn during a first coitus. The presence or absence of the hymen is not a reliable indicator of virginity. Okay, so now we complete the structure of female reproductive system.